Hello students, nice to meet you. Welcome to E class. Myself, Smita teacher. Open your EVS 1 test book, page number 7. I'm going to read the lesson. You have to listen carefully and observe. Try this. Stand a candle in the middle of a large table. Draw a big circle around the candle. Place a globe at any point on this circle. Light the candle. See that it is dark in the room. Room should be dark. That means light should be off. And in night time, you can do this activity. But with you, parents must be there because you are going to light the candle. It should be safe to you. Suppose that the candle is the sun and you have to consider the candle as a sun. Observe which part of the globe gets the sun's light and which one does not. See, in this figure, it has shown that how to arrange the candle, the globe. Instead of globe, if you don't have globe, you can take ball also. But you have to put ball on one stand. Now, looking at the globe from the direction of the North Pole, turn it anti-clockwise. What is mean by anti-clockwise? See, have you seen the hands of clock? Which hand? Second hand, minute hand, which moves, which rotates. So that is the clockwise direction. How second hand move, that is the clockwise direction. Okay, that direction is clockwise. And anti-clockwise means exactly opposite. So in this way, the hands of clock moves. And what is mean by anti-clockwise? Exactly opposite direction. Okay. This is how the earth rotates. That is IE means that is. It is the short form. It rotates from west to east. As the earth rotates, its different parts come into the light of the sun, one after the other, and turn away from it, also in the same order. Students, did you get one doubt in your mind? Why there is sunset and sunrise? In daytime, there is sun in the sky. And in night, where is it going? Okay, we will see the cycle of day and night. Sunset and sunrise. Try this. Stick a red bindi on the globe. Set up the previous model of the globe and the candle. Turn the globe anti-clockwise. Note when it is sunrise, noon, and sunset at the location of the bindi. After one sunrise, note when the next one occurs at the bindi. You will see that this happens when the earth completes one rotation. That is, when it makes one complete turn around itself. This period of time that the earth takes to complete one rotation is called a day. A day has two parts, daytime and nighttime, or simply day and night. For the purpose of measuring time, we divide the whole day into 24 parts, each of which is called an hour. Each part is called as hour. So in a day, we say there are 24 hours. Students, here I have a globe and a torch. Consider torch as a sun. With globe and torch, I'm going to explain the cycle of day and night. Earth rotates anti-clockwise. What is mean by anti-clockwise? Have you seen watch? See, it is a watch, and observe the minute hand. How it rotates, it is clockwise direction. This is clockwise direction. Okay. Now what is mean by anti-clockwise direction? Exactly opposite. See here. Now observe the minute hand exactly opposite direction. The minute hand is moving in exactly opposite direction. This is called as anti-clockwise direction. Okay. See, Earth rotates anti-clockwise. That means from west to east. The direction of rotation is from west to east. See, here is the India. I have stuck here one bindi. Okay. Now we will see how Earth rotates and the cycle of the day and night. As the Earth rotates, its different parts come into the light of the sun one after another and turn away from it also in the same order. See here, I have stuck here one bindi and anti-clockwise the globe is turning. Now see, where is the bindi? See, when bindi come at original place, it completes, the globe is completing one rotation. Are you getting? See here, I have stuck here one bindi. Again, to get original position came. So globe is completing one rotation. That means to complete one rotation, Earth makes one complete turn around itself. This period of time that the Earth takes to complete one rotation is called a day. And half part of the globe is in the dark. That means this is the day and this is the night. Now in India there is daytime, and when Earth rotates and India has come opposite, exactly opposite side of the sun, that means now India is in dark. It means in India there is night. So one day and one night means one rotation of the Earth. This period of time that the Earth takes to complete one rotation is called a day. A day has two parts, daytime and nighttime, or simply day and night. We divide the whole day into 24 parts, that means 24 hours. So students, today's homework is you have to find the meaning of anti-clockwise and write down this definition of a day in your notebook. Thank you. Have a nice day. Stay home. Stay safe.